In this segment, we're going to talk about life insurance in a low interest rate environment and retirement planning like charitable giving, legacy planning for children and grandchildren, or even final expense. It's all from Tom's book, Paychecks and Playchecks. Well, Tom, let's talk about this. I mean, when I think about it, I always think about life insurance as just an indemnification issue, but there's a lot of ways this can be used, and even in retirement planning, which shocked me.
Yeah, see, a lot of people think life insurance has nothing to do with retirement. I argue life insurance has everything to do with retirement. See, it's the life insurance you bring in retirement that allows you to spend your money. One of the reasons people live this just-in-case retirement, they never fully enjoy their retirement, is because in the back of their minds, they keep thinking, I got to leave Johnny and Susie some money. Mm-hmm. And so they deny themselves a retirement because they want to leave their kids some money. So what we did with our own retirement plan, one of the first things we did, we said, how much money do we want to leave to our kids? We want to leave them something, don't want to leave them too much. What that number was, we then bought for pennies on the dollar life insurance to go to the kids. Guess what that frees us up to do with all the rest of our money? Spend it. Now, some people don't like their kids anymore, so I always talk to them about their grandchildren because I know they love their grandchildren. Okay. So here's Annie. She's 62 years of age. She has $100,000 in a CD. She says, Tom, this is my just-in-case money. I don't need it, but I named my six grandchildren as beneficiaries. And when I die, they're each going to get $16,950. Now, that's a nice grandma. But my question is, if it's her just-in-case money, has she done the right thing and maximized it for the grandchildren? And really not. See, if she took that $100,000 and put in a life insurance policy, she could still access it if she needed it in an emergency. In fact, there are now some policies for seniors that have 100% money-back guarantee. So you put it in. If for some reason you don't want it, you get it all back. But now, each of the grandchildren would get $36,000 instead of $16,000. So CIC, don't leave your grandchildren any money either. Leave them life insurance because you can leave them so much more for so much less.
Now, this leverage idea, a lot of people have a real heart for their children, for their grandchildren. What about charities? Because they have a lot of heart for nonprofits.
Absolutely. So let's talk about charitable giving. So here's Al and Helen. They're very charitably minded. They saved up $50,000 they want to give to charity. But when they start talking about it, they each want to give $50,000. Well, how do you each give $50,000 if all you get is $50,000? You put it in a life insurance policy. It immediately creates $100,000 of gifting power to give to the charity.
Now, to me, this is powerful because a lot of people have a big heart, but they have a small wallet.
Right.
And the leverage of life insurance can really provide their benefic- or their benevolency to whatever nonprofit they like.